If there's any doubt that a 26-year career police officer named Kimberly Potter is being made an example of, I have some stunning information. Now, granted, she's never made a mistake in her life until she made a terribly tragic mistake.
Correct. Yeah.
She's not a threat to the public.
Not whatsoever.
She was not allowed by Judge Regina Chu to go home for Christmas.
That's right.
This was reported by Alpha News on Friday, January 7th, just this past Friday. I was alerted to this by emailer Paul. Judge Regina Chu declined to release Kim Potter while she awaits sentencing, despite arguments from Potter's attorneys that she poses no danger to the public whatsoever. A violent criminal with a lengthy juvenile delinquency history involving assault and weapons offenses was temporarily released from jail for a funeral by Hennepin County Judge Regina Chu, and he has not come back.
Wow.
You're kidding me.
Let's blow this out of the water.
Cheverio Kevarion Childs-Young.
Oh, my God.
Now 18, was released at 9:30 a.m. on January 3 to attend a family member's funeral. Let me stop. You want to bet that he ever even did that?
Oh, yeah, good point.
Judge Chu ordered him to report back to the Hennepin County Jail by 12:30 p.m. that same day. He never showed. Mm-hmm. Warrant issued in the amount of $40,000 due to defendant failing to return to Hennepin County Jail after temporary release, Chu wrote in an order filed a few hours later. Childs-Young was charged on December 2nd with assaulting a police officer in illegal possession of a firearm. Mm-hmm. According to a criminal complaint, officers discovered a firearm on the floorboard of his vehicle and detected the odor of marijuana when they pulled him over November 30. Because of his criminal past, Childs-Young was prohibited from possessing firearms. So a Hennepin County Sheriff's deputy placed him under arrest, which is allegedly when Childs-Young attempted to escape from custody by throwing his body out of the squad forcefully. The deputy was able to push the defendant back into the squad, and defendant kicked at the deputy, striking him in the midsection. The deputy could not shut the squad door because defendant used his legs to forcefully hold the door open.
Oh, I would have loved to try to close that door on his shins.
The criminal complaint states, Childs-Young then told a female passenger to get him and grab him up, referring to the deputy, and encouraged her to disarm the officer, according to the complaint. During this struggle, the defendant grabbed the deputy's genital area and squeezed multiple times.
Whoa.
The deputy continued to struggle to control defendant until he was able to call for emergency assistance, the complaint adds. Juvenile criminal history information is private, so the details of Childs-Young's past are unknown. However, records from his adult life describe Childs-Young as someone with a lengthy juvenile delinquency history involving assault and weapons offenses. In August, he was charged with another count of illegal possession of a firearm. The judge who released Childs-Young back into the public is the same judge who presided over the trial of Kim Potter. Judge Regina Chu ordered Potter to be taken into custody and held without bail while she awaits sentencing after she was found guilty of manslaughter in the death of Dante Wright. Potter's attorneys argued that she shouldn't be incarcerated pending sentencing because she's not a danger to the public whatsoever. It is the Christmas holiday season, and she is a devoted Catholic, no less, and there is no point to incarcerate her at this point, one of Potter's attorneys said. This is a rather unique case of someone who has law enforcement experience and was never in trouble in all her life. Chu disagreed, forcing Potter to spend Christmas in jail.
Wow.
I am going to require that she be taken into custody and held without bail, said Chu. I cannot treat this case differently than any other case. Well, you're a liar, Chu. You just treated it differently. You let this thug out, and you make her spend Christmas in jail. Don't let there be any doubt that this police officer is being made an example of. They're not going to be happy until they completely ruin her life.
Yes.
And this Judge Chu, you know what you are, lady? You're an idiot. You're an idiot.
And let's put it this way. Regina Chu is a bigger threat to my safety.
Absolutely.
Than Kim Potter is.
Absolutely.
She is not upholding the law. Is that the phrase?
Right.
She's upholding a leftist agenda.
She was appointed July 22nd, 2002 by Jesse Ventura. She was elected in 2004, 2010, and 2016, essentially unopposed. Her past employment includes some private practice. She's on a various boards like the Asian Women United of Minnesota. What else can I tell you about her? She's the fourth judicial district judge for Hennepin County. She was elected to a full term in 04, reelected in 2010 and 2016. She's a graduate of the University of Minnesota and a JD of the William Mitchell College of Law. She's 65 years old. What else can I tell you about her?
Joe, so this young man was released at what time, you said, Friday? 9:30?
9:30 a.m.
Not on Friday.
That's when it was reported. Oh, he was released on January 3rd.
Okay, so last Monday, a week ago.
He's been out doing crimes for a week.
Can you beat me to it? What do you think the over-under is on the number of crimes that this young man has already committed in 1 week's time?
What cars is he jacked?
Exactly.
How many people and can Chu be sued? What if he kills somebody? Can Chu be sued?
I don't know.
Potter sits in jail knitting. She never was going to be a threat to the public, but you people have made it your cause to ruin her life because it plays well.
Right, looks good.
You morons. Regina Chu, you are an idiot.